Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about diaphragmatic absorption, the process that's involved. This is the process that we use in our low frequency absorption technology. Process been around for years. We did not create it. We did not invent diaphragmatic absorption. It's used extensively in studio builds, a lot of times not accurately, but it is used. So it's basically a sealed chamber, a wall, a 2x4, 2x6, 2x8 interior wall sealed with drywall on both sides. It's a diaphragmatic absorber. You can actually calculate the resonant frequency and find that for that particular material type and cavity depth, and all that can be calculated. So what is diaphragmatic absorption? It's a pressure-activated device. There's no holes in it. Air doesn't move through it. Indirectly it does, but we're going to walk through the process. So it's a sealed unit that reacts on pressure. So what is pressure? Well, we know from past videos that pressure is any frequency less than 100 cycles. So it's really a low frequency technology. If it has enough horsepower like our does, obviously you can make it broadband. We take diaphragmatic absorption. We add our foam technology to the face. So with our diaphragmatic absorbers, you can get coverage from 30 up to 6,300 cycles. So that's very broadband if you need it. So lots of flexibility there to help you with tuning your room. How does it work? It converts pressure from low frequency energy below 100 cycles in this example, and it strikes the front wall. Now in our diaphragmatic absorbers, we have two walls. Most have one, but we have two that are out of phase with each other. So this back and forth out of phase movement slows this huge pressure wave down. So this back and forth movement of the dual walls forces air movement into the cavity. Into the cavity, we find our carbon. And what the carbon does is it controls the rate of absorption. The level of absorption is determined by the front wall density, stiffness ratio, and construction, the depth of the cavity, and then the density of the cavity or density of the cabinet itself. In our units, we use a dual rear wall that's sandwiched between a layer of damping compound. So we have an extremely rigid rear wall and then this layout that you see here. So the surface reacts to pressure. The pressure starts air movement on the inside of the cavity, which is filled with carbon. Carbon is very absorbent. So in a way, and it's not, I'm just using this for purposes of illustration, it's almost like a vacuum inside this thing. So a big pressure wave out here moves through this low pressure area, and that's how you get this huge amount of absorption. So there's a ratio that you have to follow in the mass and the stiffness of the front wall. There's a ratio you have to follow in the stiffness and density of the cabinet, and then the depth of the cabinet, like we discussed, will get you your resonant frequency. All frequencies below the resonant frequency will not be absorbed. All frequencies above the resonant frequency will be. So you have a lot of design variables that you have to calculate. And the internal fill material gives you the rate, how much, at what frequency, and how fast it absorbs. In what amount of space. And that's the goal, to get the most absorption in the smallest amount of space. And then the cabinet density has to have a certain density and a certain stiffness ratio to make all these variables work together. So that's the diaphragmatic process. Pressure activated, air movement on the inside, proper cabinet construction, and you can get a lot of absorption in a small amount of space if you use the right internal cabinet fill. Thank you. I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, give me a thumbs up so I know that it had value to you. And please, if you have any questions, leave them in the comment section and I'll be more than happy to answer them for you. Alternatively, if there are other topics that you wish to discuss or see discussed in a video presentation, send me an email, info@acousticfields.com, and we'll get them on our list and get them done for you. I release a new video about every week, so stay tuned to our YouTube channel and keep updated on our new videos.